case y'all don't like these motherfuckers. I'll say this, that most of us on the stage, in particular, I'll give the first part of the intro, is me, the guitars, the pianists, and the drummer come from a thing. We come from a thing that developed in this place called Mars, and the guy that invented the whole concept is a guy named Jackie McLean. Please clap for Jackie McLean. If you don't know him, look him up. The word of the day is Jackie McLean. Tonight is dedicated to just the teachings of Jackie McLean, because the one thing that he always taught is the simple concept of each one, teach one, and we all share experience, and we all are on one accord, and we all need each other. We don't want each other, but we all need each other, and that's the whole concept for the McLean machine. So that being said, we're going to start. I know you like my flower shirt. I thought it was cool too, so I bought this motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. thank you for coming out tonight. You could have been anywhere, but you're fucking with me.
Just to break the moment, I'm gonna give you a secret. We just had a moment. We just had a moment because we're never gonna play these songs again the same way ever in our lives. Ever, ever, ever. Because I can promise you, you'll never hear them again. Because we don't even know what the fuck just happened. It's just. See, that's a whole nother thing. I keep that going like that. That's hard. I wish Michael Jackson was alive, but that would be a record for him, I feel like. Whatever, y'all gotta believe. I want somebody to sing for y'all. First of all, she is an excellent vocalist in her own right, and amazing. But me being selfish, I'm gonna say that because of her and the powers that be, all of us, we actually share something together. We share a song called If These Walls Could Talk. That's nominated. I guess somebody liked it and they nominated it. Maybe we don't gotta sneak in no more. We can just walk in the front door. Fucking amazing. But she does some cool shit that I'm inspired by, so I just want her to vibe out. Yes. The wonderful, the beautiful, the queen. The herself, and she sings in tune in the studio. We don't need no auto-tune. Everything is just cool as shit, like what you're supposed to do. And Anna Wise, when she gets on your record, you get nominated for fucking Grammys. Anna Wise, y'all. Anna Wise. And she's also part of a group called Sunny Moon. And they don't, yeah, come on now. So y'all make sure y'all download her music, look her up, shake her hand, get her number. But she'll give you her fucking number. So don't give nobody your number tonight. She'll give all, don't.
Everyone.
See?
415.
There it is. Anna Wise, please, Anna Wise. She's not done. We're not done. She's gonna keep vibing out with us, and I don't know, man. Maybe we'll do some. Maybe like some To Pimp a Butterfly shit.
Ooh.
Shit. Now, what do we say on the next part? Cool. Hey, Anna.
Hey, Terrence.
Do you want to do that song we wrote called, what is the song again called, Anna?
Can Talk.
Okay. Maybe let's do that song we wrote for the people, because we've never did it before live, and we're going to start just doing these songs and just having a ball doing them because we wrote them. So this is a song that I did the music, and I didn't even know I did the music. I left the studio. I don't remember how the hell I got home that night. The last thing I remember was Volcano and Tequila. And then I just got home. But when I woke up and came to the studio, and I heard these beautiful vocals on this song called If These Walls Could Talk. And I said, Kendrick, who's that? Oh, that's Anna again. Because Anna, I met Anna on the first record. We have history there too.
Mm-hmm.
We wrote a song called Real on Good Kid, Mad City. And that's Anna. That's Anna's voice through the whole album. But that particular song, to me, you could just hear her tonality and what she's about. So it's an honor and a pleasure for me to share the same space amongst everybody else. Thank you for coming. So, hey, Anna, let's do If These Walls Could Talk.
Okay.
Anna.
Does anybody else feel like they're in the Lauryn Hill X Factor music video right now? I do. So sexy.
Just wanna close her eyes and sway with you, with you, with you. Exercise her right to work it out. It's true, it's true, it's true. Shout out to the birthday girl, say hey, say hey. Deserves a night to play. She plays only when you tell her no. Thank you.
Is this cool? Is this cool? It sounds cool out there? Okay, cool. This is part of the show. Well, you guys are officially really part of the band. But I can't pay nobody past this stage. So, you guys know art is beautiful, right?
Yes.
You guys know art is love and everything. And I'm sure there's a lot of artists in here, some that aren't, but the thing about art, and this is why we're all gonna be one band, because we need each other for real. This is for real shit. The thing about art, what keeps art moving is the fellowship and the support. I know we all know that, everybody knows that, but we don't do it enough, I feel. This is beautiful. And one thing about New York is a lot of the cool art shit going on. In LA, it gets tricky sometimes, but I always want to tell everybody, art is funded by love and by spirit and people showing up to the building. All you have to do is show up and art will keep living. The minute you guys stop showing up, art ends up dying. And this is why it took forever for us to do To Pimp a Butterfly, because we felt like it was a void in hip hop. Meaning we felt like some of the hip hop people have just forgot their roots, where the music comes from. You know, and they left the art. They left the building, so they left soul music, and soul music couldn't live anymore. You know what I'm saying? Because people stopped showing up. So it's very important that we show up to everything. And show up means support the artist. Go see an artist. Go pay for the ticket. It's okay. You can pay for the ticket. Buy a CD or just tweet them, we appreciate you. That's what keeps the art going. And that's why I always say we're all one, because without you, it's no us. Without us, it's no you. It's vice versa. So clap for yourself. Clap for yourself. Jump up and down one time. Jump up and down. Oh, that shit is cool. You guys, listen to me. Okay, listen, stop. Don't do that. That was cool, man. We're going to keep on playing. That was cool. Thank you for doing that.
She just wanna close her eyes and sway with you, with you, with you. Exercise her right to work it up. It's true, it's true.
So I have an album coming out. Damn.
Woo!
Hey, I have an album coming out to help support my family too. Cool. Anyway, my album is called Velvet Portraits. It comes out today. I'm gonna say April 1st. I think it's April 1st. They said they tell me when it's gonna come out. So April 1st. But it's a song on there. First of all, I'm not gonna tell you the concept. It's too long. Okay, nothing. I'm not gonna do it. But it's a I come from an area in Los Angeles. Are you guys familiar with Los Angeles? Anyway, I come from an area in Los Angeles called the Crenshaw District. And it's on Crenshaw and Slauson, and it's a cool area, and it's fun, and we grew up there, a lot of good music, a lot of vibe, and Nipsey was around, and rap music came, and corrupted over there. And then the other side to the shit is that you could get killed. Bottom line, I'm not even laughing. Like, you could, it was cool, but I grew up in a time when gangbanging was being stirred up, you know, late 80s, 90s, and everything. So it was a lot of senseless self-hate crimes going on within my community of South Central Los Angeles. But the good times about South Central and the Crenshaw District was cool because my mother always played, like, Donny Hathaway. Like, my mother played, you know, Donny Hathaway and then during that era, Layla Hathaway, I came out with an album as well. But it was something, she always played the Donny Hathaway album. Every time we'd drive down Crenshaw, she'd drive me off at the YMCA. Those were miserable days. Fucking YMCA, everybody my age talking about toys. I'm thinking about Coltrane. It's the weirdest shit ever. But she would always play Donny Hathaway live on cassette. And it would be worn out, you know. My mother would never buy a new cassette. She'd keep playing the same one till everything was slow. You know, and it's a song on there called Valdez in the Country that I really love that Donny Hathaway played live. So since I grew up off Crenshaw, Maverick Flats, the Murray Park, and everything like that, I was inspired by palm trees and beautiful women and everything Crenshaw has to offer. The medicine, everything is there. But anyway, I imagine if Donny Hathaway was just hanging out on Crenshaw, how would he play Valdez in the Country? So I renamed his song, and as we do in hip hop, and I named it Valdez off Crenshaw, because I got a homie named Leonel Valdez. That's funny, but he really lived on 53rd and Crenshaw, so it's like a tribute to Leon. He sold incense. Don't worry about it. If you see me, dog, I got you. I got you on that dollar pack of incense. But this is Valdez off Crenshaw, y'all, inspired by Donny Hathaway and just growing up in Crenshaw, smelling incense, seeing gangbang, but then seeing a real unity thing in my neighborhood. And that's what I stand for, unity, and for your house first. And when your house is right, then you can fuck with everybody else. So this is a tribute to my house and my neighborhood on Crenshaw, Slauson, and Valdez off Crenshaw. Thank you. Whoa. Hey. We just bought. Yeah, break it down. We just brought South Central LA to New York City. Whoa. That was cool. Jump up and down. Okay, good, good. Yeah, man. Fuck, man. I love you guys, man. I'm gonna take you on tour for that. Cool, thank you, man. How much time we have? What? Y'all like Earth, Wind & Fire? Y'all don't even know who they are. So since nobody's giving me a time when to stop, I'm gonna keep playing. Whoa! How long have we been playing? So this is the part since we don't know. We'll take some cool shit like this. Drum solo. I can clap, y'all. I told y'all part of the band. Keep clapping. Say, go, JB, go, JB, yo. Say, go, JB, go, JB, go. The look like you killed it, like, yeah. Man, that is, well, you know what? That's a good way to kill the time, too. I like that. Thank you. Now, keep in mind, listen, I'm gonna tell y'all what happened later on today, but right now, I'm gonna let him play, then I'm gonna introduce him. Actually, I'm gonna let JB introduce him. I'm gonna tell you why. I just met everybody months ago, and I'm old. I don't remember these two cats' last name, but I know they play their ass off. And they my homeboys, and they keep saying, look, they said Terrace, man, so you don't have to introduce us, because I know last time you didn't say her last name, but my last name is, and I had it, that, and I was like, cool. Now, what's your last name, Andrew? He told me his last name. So I kept thinking about the last names on the way to the stage, and I said, I got an idea. What would Snoop Dogg do? So I said, hey, JB, because look, since I met them through you, and you're my guy, and they my guys, but they're more your guys because you know these guys longer than me, I'm going to let you introduce the band. And he looked at me crazy, like, dude, you just pretty much like learned the fucking last names. What's crazy, I just remembered my mother's birthday yesterday. For all my life, I knew it was between April 4th and April 8th. Is that bad? But that's how you know it's not personal. It's just, and I love my mother. She's been texting me that I feed the dogs while I'm being on this fucking stage right now. And I'm way in New York. I love my mother. But I want to hear the bass player play. So listen, this is my first time playing with him. We're sharing a moment. that's another example how the art works. I don't know him, but we both played the blues. So we'll get through the night. And it's been more of a treat, y'all. This is you guys' first time hearing him, and my time first time hearing him. Are you guys happy? Because I'm happy. Well, that's John Michelle, y'all. Ladies, this next dude just won the lottery. He's single. And he plays like he has a Jerry Curl. His name is Andrew. Be gentle when he's done playing, ladies. Be gentle. My own boy Andrew on guitar. I want to just fuck y'all up real quick. Ooh, that's pressure. That's pressure. I just said fuck y'all up. That's pressure. I get a nickname for him. Hold on, man. Let me get y'all, because I'm from LA, bro. Ooh, that's that jazz shit first and last name. I'm going to call him. Let me get him a name. Hold on. Let me think. We're going to call him Gangsta Andrew. Because I always remember motherfuckers named Gangsta because I don't fuck with them, but I like him. So, hey, y'all, give it up for Gangsta Andrew right now. So I got my other little homie. This dude is funny. He's a shy kind of fella, but he's a beast on the keys. All that slick shit y'all hearing, that's him back there. He just smiles and plays. Look. That's because he hasn't got hit with an IRS bill or something. Some crazy woman come through his life and wipe him crazy, so he's just like this. I didn't been through all that shit, so I'm still like, I'm playing. But he actually plays his innocence and his sincerity at the same time, and he comes from the South, so let me, y'all act like this shit don't come from the South? Y'all not gonna clap for the South? Okay, come on now. Okay, Lee, like, well, Brooklyn's pretty stand up, man. It's my homie Tabor. I'm not gonna say his last name wrong. Who said Gabriel? Who wants to bet it's Gabriel? Or it's Gable? Y'all, this is Tabor Gable. And he's amazing, y'all. He's amazing. And he always smiling. Don't smile, young man. Smile. Keep smiling, brother.
y'all got a lot of fucking stories. I got so many damn stories. People hate when I tell my stories. My kids hate when I tell my stories. But since y'all love me, I love y'all. I'm gonna tell one more story. So, this is only my second headline show in New York City ever. And it's a person, it's like a battery pack. That's what we call them in LA. Battery packs keep the shit going, because without the battery packs and the people that understand the culture because they're in the culture and they're part of it, the people that don't mind staying up and down on those computers, typing those big ass words and cease and desist and all these weird things and long, you know, but we need those to keep our thing going. And it's the person that obviously believes in me and believes in the movement that I'm a part of, she's a part of, Kamasi Washington's a part of, Thundercat's a part of, Kendrick Lamar's a part of, Robert Glasper's a part of, Keon Harrell's a part of. But she has a situation. I like to call it a blanket because it feels so warm when you deal with her and her people. But it's called Revive. Are you guys in? Well, maybe y'all motherfuckers need to revive! Because Revive and Megan is the reason why that I'm up here playing for you all today. So, yo, y'all, this is, okay, come on now. Hold up, I'm gonna say this. Y'all don't understand, and I'm not gonna tell y'all that story, but I'm tired as fuck. I'm tired than a motherfucker right now, and I just love playing, and I have a person that believes in me and believes in you enough to bring us together in a unionship, a covenant. That's bigger than what you motherfuckers think it really is, because without her, I wouldn't be here. A lot of things wouldn't be floating around New York City that she doesn't get credit for. So once again, y'all, that's Megan from Abad, the reason I'm here. Y'all clap for the homegirl cousin. I want to thank you, you. We'll be right back. Everybody get home safely on the subways, the Ubers. I know y'all motherfuckers don't drive out here, so however y'all get there, y'all get there. And be careful. I love y'all.